This video will give detailed information about the buttons built into DJI RS2, as well as how to access the most frequently used shooting modes quickly. Press and hold the power button to power on DJI RS2. The touchscreen will automatically display the homepage, where you can access auto-tune, balance status, follow mode, and follow speed. In the top bar of the touchscreen, you can also check user profile, camera connection status, battery level, and other information. Tap the auto-tune icon at the top left to enter auto-tune. Tap to start auto-tune, and the gimbal will adjust its stabilization according to the actual payload, providing better stabilization. Tap the slider to eliminate or disable Super Smooth. It will take effect after you perform auto-tune again, as this determines the gimbal's adjusted stiffness. Super Smooth stiffness can be adjusted on the auto-tune screen. You can refer to the icon at the top right corner to check the balance status. Green indicates the gimbal is well balanced. Orange indicates the gimbal is adequately balanced for use. And red indicates the gimbal is out of balance and requires a rebalance before use. Tap the follow mode icon and scroll up and down the screen to select a follow mode. Tap the follow speed icon and scroll up and down the screen to set the follow speed. Press and hold to power on or off. Press to lock or unlock the touchscreen, or press twice to enter or exit sleep mode. Joystick, toggle to control the movement of the gimbal. M button, press to select a user profile. Camera control button. After connecting DJI RS2 to the camera with a multi-camera control cable, press halfway to initiate autofocus. Press once to start or stop recording, and press and hold to take a photo. Trigger. Press once to start active track. Press twice to recenter the gimbal. Press three times to turn the gimbal 180 degrees and enter selfie mode. Front dial. The front dial's default function is to control camera focus. It can also be used to control focus motor, ISO, aperture, or the roll axis. Auto tune. Press and hold the M button and trigger to initiate auto tune. Lock mode. Press and hold the trigger to enter lock mode. In this mode, the camera will keep facing the same direction no matter how the handle moves. Lock mode is useful for shots that involve tracking or pan follow. Sport mode. Press and hold the M button to enable sport mode, in which the gimbal tracks a quickly moving subject. If you need to remain in sport mode, press the trigger twice while holding the M button. Perform the same action to exit sport mode. Portrait mode. Press the M button twice or set the follow mode on the touchscreen to portrait mode. The pan and tilt axes will rotate 90 degrees so that the camera is vertical. Press the M button twice to exit portrait mode. 3D Roll 360. Press the M button three times to enable 3D Roll 360 or set the follow mode on the touchscreen to 3D Roll 360. Where the tilt axis will rotate 90 degrees upward and stand by for a 360-degree rotation. At this moment, the camera is facing the same direction as the grip. Push the joystick to the left or right, and the camera will make a 360-degree rotation. Push the joystick to the left or right twice, and the camera will keep rotating at a constant speed. Press the trigger twice, and the gimbal will automatically stop once it is in a horizontal direction. Press the trigger three times, and the gimbal will automatically stop once the camera view is inverted. Repeat to exit 3D Roll 360. Thanks for watching! Hit the like button if this tutorial was helpful. If you need any support with your DJI gear, feel free to contact us via Facebook Messenger by following the link in the description. Thank you for watching.